It was day two in the trial of two men charged with a murder at Shawnee Park.
Jurors heard testimony about the physical evidence against the suspects accused of killing 22-year-old Antonio Anderson. Ann Bowden listened to the testimony in the courtroom today. She joins us live outside the Judicial Center with more. Ann?
Well, Rick and Vicki, one word took center stage today, and that's evidence. Physical evidence and eyewitness testimony took center stage on the stand today, and it played heavily against the two accused, Quentin Wilson and William Smith.
A pair of socks with possible blood. And this one is CSU's exhibit number 4, pair of shoes with possible blood.
Bags and bags of evidence fill the witness stand Thursday. Police and evidence technicians testified to the items they found on the scene after a panicked crowd scattered from Shawnee Park back in August of 2011. One who didn't make it out, 22-year-old Antonio Anderson.
CSU's exhibit number 1 is boxer shorts with possible blood and possible defects.
Defects or the bullet holes left from the fatal shots that killed him. Prosecutors say 22-year-old William Smith and 27-year-old Quentin Wilson were among a group of trigger men who fired into a large crowd at Shawnee Park 2 years ago. Antonio Anderson was killed and two others injured. Testimony today focused on the evidence from Anderson's riddled and bloodstained clothing, but it also included the gun recovered at the scene and eyewitness statements that identified the gun and the suspects.
And the first subject that he looked at was later identified as Quentin Wilson. Mr. Keller stated the subject was one of the first people who ran by him after the incident and saw him holding a handgun.
Detective Cohn also testified the witness identified William Smith as well.
The next person was a male later identified as William Smith. He described him as the subject that he saw run by him carrying what he described as a black handgun or a 9. Referring to an automatic 9mm.
Now, Rick and Vicki, the defense claims that Quentin Wilson and Smith didn't have any guns at the time of that melee in Shawnee Park. They claim that their clients were running out of the park in a panic, just like everyone else. But, of course, the prosecution doesn't agree with that story. The third day of testimony is expected to begin tomorrow as the prosecution continues to call up between 35 and 45 witnesses. Here outside of the Judicial Center, Ann Bowden, WLKY News.